Hey YouTube, this is Kerry Scrapping for Dart. Well, I get a lot of questions on how much do I pay for computer towers when I pay for them. Sometimes I get them for free, sometimes I don't. So I decided to go through and make a breakdown of what I found that I'll be making out of a computer tower if I pull out all the components. And I separated this into a couple different categories to show you. Basically, you can take every component in a computer, figure out what your yard is paying you or what your buyer is paying you, and then you can figure out your price per pound or per ounce. So basically, like for my computer towers, I did the experiment. I'll have a power supply hole, not opened. I get 41 cents. Ribbon wire, 4 cents. Insulated wire, 15 cents. My boards, mother, PCI, DVD, CD-ROM, and floppy, I get paid $3 a pound for that stuff mixed. So I get like 2 pounds, so I get $6. There's different types of heat sinks in computers, so basically an aluminum heat sink, I get about 36 cents for per tower. If it's copper aluminum, I get about 72 cents. Tin, 29 cents for the whole shell of the computer and screws. Memory, RAM, 52 cents each. CPU fiber with metal or copper top, 40 cents each. CPU fiber with no metal, 29 cents each. And then basically ceramic, about 97 cents each. This is low end, and remember some CPUs can sell for 20, 30 bucks each. This depends. You have to do your research. There's motors and transformers, I get 7 cents. Dirty brass, about 2 cents. And the hard drive hole, 25 cents, that's not opened up. So the total for all of that is about $8.51 per tower is what I make in scrap. So I broke this down also. If I did not, so total tower price not including the power supply and the hard drive would be about $7.85. And the reason I separated that out is because I opened a power supply, and since prices of power supplies have dropped, it's now worth more money for me to open power supplies. So here's the breakdown. Tin, 3 cents in a power supply. Dirty brass, 1 cent. Motors, transformers, 10 cents. The heat sinks, 19 cents. Insulated copper wire, 3 cents. And then the windings from the number 2 copper inside, about 24 cents. So if I open a power supply, it's worth 60 cents. If I didn't, it's 41 cents. Same with the hard drive. If you open it, all of a sudden your aluminum separated out, including the platters, 24 cents. The magnets I sell for a buck a set. The motor is about 1 cent. And the board is worth about 57 cents. So the whole total hard drive open is $1.82 versus 25 cents if you leave it whole. So the grand total separated all the computer components is 1027. And this is a low end estimate. And that again means I'm assuming like the lowest grade heat sink, just aluminum, not copper aluminum. I'm assuming the lowest grade CPU and not ceramic. So prices will go up from there. And then how do you figure out the formulas? This is how I do it. This is how I wrote it out. First thing you want to do is find out what your buyer is paying per pound. You divide the price by 16 because there's 16 ounces per pound, and that gets you a price per ounce. Then you multiply the ounces by the price per ounce, and that's how you figure it out. So an example would be my yard is paying 61 cents a pound for heat sinks. If I have, for example, 6 ounces, this is how we figure it out. I take 61 cents divided by 16 to get four cents per ounce, and then I take the 6 ounces that I have for my heat sink times 4 cents, gets me 24 cents. So this is how much my 8 ounce heat sink is worth. So basically I wrote, you can do this for any type of scrap. So no matter what you want to figure out the ounces in, you can do it just by using this formula. So I hope this answers the questions for people wondering how much they should pay for a tower if they're going to buy it from somebody. I personally don't pay more than $3 a tower. That's with hard drive. Without, I'll pay $2 a tower. So again, you get this stuff for free. That's great. If you can't and you're buying from somebody, then this is the formula that I go by. So it's going to be different for everybody, and all these prices are going to differ. But you can use all these same categories and just figure out everything per ounce or per pound. Hope this video helps you all out. Please like and subscribe. Take care.